Good evening. I'm Nicholas Hoare for PBS. My feline companion is a dear friend by the name of Pippin, named improbably after a peculiar British fruit called Cox's Orange Pippin, a wonderful apple for those who like something that is sharp and brisk. Leaving apples aside, but not cats. My passion in life is dogs and cats. And for some strange reason, the New Yorker, of whom I'm immensely fond, shares that passion. And over the years, they have produced a succession of absolutely delightful books based on a combination of text and, at the same time, cartoons, both of which they excel at. And I'm thinking in this particular case of one particular book, which is very much still in print and which remains a classic of its type. Now, I could go on and include dogs. I won't. So for the purpose of this discussion, let us go over to this shelf and have a look at exactly what has come out of this remarkable magazine over the years. These books on three shelves are 100% New Yorker. And one of those books is this delightful tome called The Big New Yorker Book of Cats. Now, for those who prefer the dog as opposed to the cat, there is, of course, the equivalent for dogs. But my interest is in this creature and that book. And if you wish to have a really fun cross-sectional view of the New Yorker in all its glory, with text from the obvious James Thurber and co, Henry Cooper, you name it, along with a collection of cartoons that simply ice the cake, I commend it highly. Still in print, great fun, and vintage New Yorker. And on that catty note, good evening.